Yeah, I want to talk to Otto. We haven't heard from Otto
yet.
Yes.
Yeah, Otto's shy.
Otto's going to speak next.
He's a great fighter. No one ever hears from Otto. Yeah. We only hear from George.
He didn't bring George today.
Why?
No. George is home.
That's creepy.
I was working in Staten Island last night at a place called Illusions, and Adolf Hitler was at the bar. I said, "What are you doing?" He goes, I'm going to kill 6 million Jews and 5 circus clowns. I said, 5 circus clowns? He goes, see, nobody cares about the Jews. Hey, Otto. Otto, is there any ventriloquist?
Hold on. I just want to hear Voss try to say ventriloquist again.
Oh, no.
What is a ventriloquist? A guy with a fucking talking fucking...
I stopped it.
I was going to say talking van.
I'm not good.
Can I ever tell you the greatest Jewish joke I ever heard in my life?
Oh, I got one. What?
Told by Roger Rittenhouse with the hook on his hand.
Can we make this perfectly clear? It's a joke.
It's a joke. It's a joke.
All of media is listening to us right now.
Great first day back. You don't got me shaking enough, you motherfuckers.
But listen, it's a joke. I give Roger Rittenhouse the credit. The dude with the hook on his hand. I heard him years ago.
You're about to hear a joke. This is a joke.
Should I not do it? It's not an
anti... It's... Again.
You know what?
Again and again.
I don't want to be the Paul Michael Mercurio.
Wait, Patrice.
I won't do it.
Patrice, as a Jew, I'd like to hear it.
Yeah.
All right. Good enough.
No, but you don't count. Jews reject you because you're stupid.
And you got tattooed.
You're a tattooed
Jew. Do not acknowledge
that. You've gone against part of their religion by getting your body marked up with tattoos.
So is every Jew that has plastic surgery.
Is Miss Wolf Jewish?
I'm a Jew.
And so is Otto.
Otto is Jewish.
I've never had a problem. So the joke was funny. It basically was when Schindler's List came out.
Oh,
when
no.
The movie came
that's got to be a scream.
No, wait a minute.
All right, let me get my finger back.
When Schindler's List came out, right, the guy goes, hey, you know what? This Schindler's List is going to be a big movie because Steven Spielberg, I heard they're doing a deal with McDonald's that they're going to promote the movie. He said, I can't wait to collect all 6 million cups.
That's pretty funny.
Okay.
That's a great joke, man.
That's funny. Here's a Jew joke.
No. No.
Let's
try to make it through the summer, all right?
One day.
I'd like to make it through Jones Beach.
I would like to make it to noon today.
Yeah. I think that was in the same tone as that.
One day. I think you got to understand we're a bit nervous right now. The fuck did we invite so many people into the studio today?
Why a bunch of comics?
I know. It should have been.
People who never know what not to say.
It shouldn't even have been Jim. It should have been me and Opie.
Yeah.
Opie and Andy, just like the website said. Fucking cocksuckers. I'm thinking just me with a few records. That's it. Maybe I'll call in.
Opie's mid-morning attitude.
Hey, we got
the
our first
virus
show.
Is now WSKO.
Yes.
Jazz all the time.
We got our first show. Yes, we do. No. Oh, no. Come on.
The whole media's listening. Let's let them hear your George Burns impression.
Shut up.
1994.
Shut up. It's a good setup. We got an unofficial roast about to happen.
No.
Oh, man. I like
no.
it.
We'll decide. I don't know.
Oh, my God. What are all these creeps?
Debbie, thank you. Debbie Wolf, everybody. Thank you so much.
I didn't say the website, so let me say it real quick before every message board yells at me. It will be peopleagainstcensorship.com. Next week, we'll be back better than ever.
And we will promote that for you, too.
I have a new favorite fan site, too. What?
Yeah?
Yeah.
What Which is?
Not Sweetie. Say.
Oh, go ahead.
Not going to promote it.
Okay.
Deb, can I get a good look?
What? Good look.
A little turnaround
action. Oh. Turnaround?
She's now a spokesperson.
She's
on the news now. She's a pundit.
She's walking out in a second.
Yeah, you got to get on Palpog if you want to see her ass later.
Debbie never even showed her bra. It would disgust me.
You'll see her in a towel.
She was very aggravating to watch when you first met her because you'd see her and you'd watch her for like 3 hours and she'd do nothing.
She wouldn't even slip with a skirt on. No. She would just sit like she was riding a horse side saddle.
Two dimensional cock tease.
Sorry.
All right.
Thank you.
Get out of here so we can take a look at your ass.
All right. Look.
There you go.
All
right.
Lovely.
I like that. In a skirt. Yeah.
Debbie's lovely.
She did a lot for us.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's
gotta
been great.
Be acknowledged.
And the whole and all the fans have been, man. It's very appreciated. All the ones that were involved with the sites that showed up. You know what? Because special interest groups that complain never have a counterbalance of people going, wait a minute, you fucking, this is not wrong to say, you leaving people alone. And Jimmy, it was nice to have that.
To add to that, we don't trust any company at this point to stick up to special interest groups. So what you got to do is you got to like create your own special interest group and fight special interest group against themselves.
Right.
Yeah, and it's not
your group against theirs.
It's not XM or CBS. It's every company. It's movie company. I don't trust anybody either. Television people, none of them.
Yep.
So your only hope is to have your own special interest group and fight the people trying to get you in trouble.
Just cross the legs.
I could see a panty when she crossed the legs.
Serious conversation about
what?
You're having serious conversation and Patrice is just trying to see her panties.
Patrice doesn't give a shit if we're here, if we're fired.
Hey, he was on shows defending us with the donkey punch and the fucking pirate.
They call me a tap dancing nigger because I'm sitting there saving white guy trying to. Oh Lord, and that Master Imus, he didn't do nothing wrong. Nappy headed hoes. Why don't those little nigglets just get over it?
All right, so maybe you do care.
You fucking assholes. Motherfuckers call me a sellout every 5 fucking minutes because only white people know I am. Who's this nigga with a woman's name defending these crackers?
You had a dilemma, though, because you were getting some sweet TV time.
You really were.
Nigga, I took a real L. I took an L having a point. I should have just went on there and go, PatriceO'Neal.com.
Yeah, plugs.
Trying to be serious. But I was trying to make a point with these fucking goddamn white guys. And Sean Hannity, that motherfucker was like, good, thanks for John. Because, you know, John stole me from Sean.
Oh, right, right.
Because he comes on like 4 hours early, and John's like, get this dude in here. I want to steal him just because.
Yeah, well, that blew up in his fucking face.
Uh-huh.
When you said kick her in the shin and ejaculate in her eye, it was just, I was watching going like, he didn't fucking just say that. You can't say that on the radio. You can't say that on fucking news.
Like, the head of a women's league.
Yeah, with now woman sitting right next to her. Yeah. Right next to him.
He proved our point, though. When you're just flying by the seat of your pants,
you're
shit
just
happens.
Talking, and everybody in the studio is cracking the fuck up. Girls, everybody. And he was laughing. Because he knew, and he's like, I like to apologize for what came out of his fucking mouth.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
All right. We're going to take a break. We got, wow, how many people are out
there?
There's
a lot.
There's a lot of people, man.
And looks like the fucking Hamas takeover. See? Make it topical.
Jones Beach tomorrow night. That's what we want to really push today with all these guys and a few others that are not in studio today.
Looks like the Tickets white side of a prison out there.
Wait, where's the CBS News crew?
We told them to get lost.
Oh, that was
get lost.
They were going to get a lovely little white man's ass show.
Scram. Hey, oh, that would have been nice.
Yeah, I would have stood up and let them take a good peek.
Good all morning.
Right.
Send me.
Yeah?
All right, let's take a break.
Yeah.
And, wait, because she's...
No. Who's that guy? Just get us out of here.
This is an emergency broadcast. The unpleasant noise you are about to hear coming from your radio is not a mistake.
Opie and Anthony.
All right. We're back. Da, 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 da.
Patrice O'Neal, Jim Norton,
can I apologize?
Rich Voss, Bob Kelly, Otto from Otto and George. 2, 4, 5 out of the 9 comedians that you'll see tomorrow night at Jones Beach.
Thank you, sweetie.
Out there on Long Island. What?
I just want to apologize.
For what? For almost getting us fired already?
If I say anything that offended anybody, I just was repeating a joke that a guy said that I heard, and I was not in any way trying to say anything fucked up, and I'm trying to be as contrite as possible, and I do apologize.
We're just a little nervous. It's been a weird 30 days.
I understand, you know, you do understand. But you know what, too? But we got to be honest, fellas. We it's a lot of built up. We're like the bear. We're like,
you're right.
There's a lot of built up, just radio testosterone.
Yep.
You know that we'll be blurting out. You know.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we don't want to get anybody in trouble.
No, we want to have a good time.
But I don't want to get no white men fired.
I want a George Burns impression.
Shut up.
I want to hear.
You know, oh, we got to hear it, dude. Stop the bullshit.
I want to hear a George Burns impression.
I hate
this
the idea.
This is an anniversary show. Come on,
everyone,
man.
Everyone is here.
Why? You're a little eager. I love it. It's sweet, Anthony.
Let me explain something.
Andy, let's
I was
hear it.
In construction for my entire working life. I just started getting into radio because I had done an O.J. Simpson song parody. Opie played it on his show when he was doing radio at WBAB out on Long Island. And the crowd, his audience thought it was very good. Opie invited me, my brother, to come down and perform it live. When we did this, I was drinking heavily.
Put a cigar in your mouth and just say it.
I was
shut up.
I was drinking pretty good.
God.
I was drinking pretty good to, you know, calm down a little bit. And the fact is, I hadn't done a radio like that. But I was so eager to be good and to... I'm trying to explain myself, you motherfucker. Oh, this is not going to go well.
It's going to be fun. This I like
is,
it.
Shut up, Jimmy, you motherfucker. You're the worst. When this fucking tape gets played every time, you are the worst.
Why?
Because you sit there with this fake... No, it was good. It was really good.
I like to hear...
No, can I be the judge of it? Can I just
It's so
listen?
Bad. You know I what? Can't fucking... I'm too happy... Like, everything is, like, I'm too happy to be there. And that was embarrassing.
You know what's amazing about this whole thing? I have a note here. The last time we attempted to play this was in February, and we got through, like, 7 minutes.
And we have an hour.
Can you please?
It was so fucking hard.
Put it in. Just a little bit.
It is
a little.
So hard to hear this horseshit.
Now, what happened was my toilet broke
Anthony doesn't like letting his guard down.
I understand.
It is like 13, 14 years ago. At least you have an excuse. I was already doing radio for 10 years.
You two, you know what? Motherfuckers know less about these two motherfuckers than you'll ever know. Like, I know more about myself.
Yes.
Hey, we're not stupid.
I'm sitting there going, I was like, wow, I didn't know that about me on this motherfucking show.
I told people I fucked the sink. These cocksuckers won't reveal anything. Do the impression.
I brought up showering when my father made us all shower at the same time. That was fucking embarrassing.
That was a trade off to get the car keys.
What happened?
My father was teaching me and my brother how to shower.
You're afraid to wipe your ass and get some shit on it?
At 27?
He was teaching us when, I don't know, I guess I was about 6 or something, and my brother was probably 7, and he thought, bath time was over.
Were you doing George Burns so he stopped?
No, I wasn't doing George Burns.
Or did he go, that's how it started. He goes, hey, kid, smoke this cigar.
Try to say goodnight, Gracie.
That's what I said.
Say goodnight, Daddy. Goodnight, Daddy.
And I was petrified because he was standing under the water from the shower, and I was standing, me and my brother were standing on the back, like, wall where there wasn't water, and the water was running down his body. And you know how when you shower, the water runs off the head, it runs right off the head of your cock. And I kept, he was like, come here, and I'll show you how to shampoo your hair and stuff. And I'm like, no, you're going pee-pee.
Because
it looked like he was taking a leak.
I thought he just made you and your brother take it. He got in with you.
Oh, yeah, he was in the shower. And to a kid, because I'm like, he's my dad. His cock looked like it was like 2 feet long.
Did he teach you how to sleep together, too?
Daddy, what's that?
What's
a finger, and you know where that's going.
No, there was nothing sexual about it.
Wait a minute.
You just said water going down your father's body, down his cock, into your mouth. What's not sexual about that, homo?
It wasn't sexual.
You had a homemade super soaker going right in your eye.
Was there a lot of woo noises?
No.
Every time you go past the fountain, you get a hard on now?
No. Did he teach you how to lie to a counselor, too?
One of those little cupids out with the water's coming out of the dick.
Come on,
look at Atlas. In his
He doesn't throw change in it. He throws himself in it and starts sucking its cock.
Look at that statue of Hercules.
It wasn't sexual. He was teaching his sons how to shower.
Really?
They were saying when they taught Ed Norton how to shower in American history.
did, he, Whether he was stunned, did he trade you to the Aryan Brotherhood?
No! I didn't know that lifting up your left butt cheek was part of showering.
Daddy, is that a hard lupus?
Quiet, kid.
No! It was a father teaching his kid how to shower. But I didn't want to go near him because what? The water was running off and it looked like he was taking a leak.
What kind of rag is that, Daddy?
It had nothing to do with that.
Hold on, that motherfucker dressed sexy to get more drugs from a fucking...
Yeah. Oh, look at him sticking up.
Thank you.
I'm trying to defend Andy.
Yeah. Okay.
Andy, stop. All right.
Hey, hold on, wait a minute. Hold on, son. Let me smack this soap on your ass cheek.
It wasn't like that.
Let me put it. Come on.
If anybody knows a queer, it'd be fucking Vaughn.
Thank you, Jimmy. It wasn't anything like that.
Oh, yeah. You've lost Jimmy. You've lost me and Andrew.
Why are you attacking me?
Let's go.
You brought it up. You only defended him because of your skeleton. Fucking bathtub experiences, okay?
His brother almost drowned trying to give himself a blowjob in the bathtub. Trying to get the heat off me, motherfucker. I'm throwing his brother under the bus.
His brother tried to blow himself in the shower?
In the bathtub.
Yeah,
famous
story on the show.
And he was underwater. Bad. His face was underwater, and he had a snorkel in his mouth.
No.
It was his dick, and his mother walked in.
My mom walked in because she was knocking on the door, didn't hear anything, and she was always paranoid that we were dying. So she walks in, and he's under the water blowing himself. He pops out of the water.
Like a Navy SEAL.
She ran down the hall screaming for my dad, going, "Freddie Bretzky!"
Is that what happened with you,
Hold
Anthony?
On. And then no. Brett ran after him, soaking wet with a hard-on, going, "Mom, I'm not gay because I was getting it.
I wasn't giving it."
Something like that, yeah. I wanted to get one. I didn't want to give one.
That's what happened with Anthony. His dad caught him doing it, and he goes, "Son, if you're going to practice, let me show you a real one."
No.
There's nothing wrong with that.
There was nothing like that at all. It was just this fear that he was urinating, and I wanted him to finish before he showed me how to shampoo my hair.
Where was he? Was you and your brother?
He was.
You're acting like you had a walk-in shower.
No, it was your basic Long Island tub and shower.
You couldn't be like 9 feet away.
I was against the wall.
You were like an inch away.
They were playing Ring Around the Rosie.
And he was standing under the water facing the back wall of the shower, and we were against the back wall facing him. So he's...
And the good thing about the shower, they can't see the tears coming out of your eyes.
He's killing you.
I know, but because all I have to work with is the truth. That's all I have.
Hey, fucker.
Was it weird? Was it weird when you saw white shower water coming off of Daddy's penis?
Wow. There wasn't any. Stop it.
Shower water. It wasn't washing off.
Suddenly, I don't want to drink this smoothie while I'm telling this story.
Daddy, they didn't even invent liquid soap yet.
It looked like conditioner. What the hell?
Daddy, did you bring eggs into the shower?
Bobby brings it right to food. Right to food.
All right, see, we have enough material. We don't have to play this.
No. Put that shit on, dude. You got to.
I want Voss to wipe his mustache off.
Did he dip you? Did he dip you in one foot?
No, he didn't dip me. I wouldn't even go near him.
Are you playing any games like Duck Duck Fag?
I just...
Fag, you're in! And you're always going to be it!
I just tried... I stayed away, so it didn't work out. The whole showering learning thing didn't work out. It ended with me crying because I didn't want to go. Well, because I didn't want to go near him while I thought he was urinating.
Did he paint duck ears on it?
No, he didn't. You are the worst. Oh, it had nothing to do with it.
Tell that to Child Services.
I am better off with the George Burns audio.
A loofah sponge hanging.
No, he didn't have a loofah. Yeah.
Jesus. Yes, I know this much. We'll never get past a minute.
I know.
That's okay.
I know.
Let's hear a little bit. We don't want to see anybody.
You will now see me put my head down and not look at anyone until this is done.
I don't know, dude.
Until the water gets turned off.
Shut up, boss.
He's killing you.
At least it was my own dad, not a fucking crack dealer.
Ooh. Oh, now there's hostility. It's not my fault. I didn't bring it up. I didn't even know the story.
At least they were taking a shower, boss.
Yeah. At least it was clean.
Yeah, so they could wash the guilt off of each other.
Anthony wants to dress sexy to get more drugs from a male drug dealer, and you're killing my pal.
Little cute Anthony wasn't trying to get head.
You know what? Opie really is annoyed. I know. He's getting. Omi's trying to bring it back to your crackness.
Did he get the upper hand?
Wait, you know what?
One time in 5 years, I finally. I have a couple comebacks. I'm sorry that I've taken loads for 5 years from you fucking two jackasses. All right? I didn't even slobber until I started doing this fucking show, okay? Fuck you guys. I talked right before I came here.
That's why boss is like he is, because his dad. He wouldn't shower.
Boss would stand in the shower and go, Boss had perfect dictation before he started doing this show.
fucking
Boss used to have perfect diction. You didn't stammer.
It was never a problem. Okay, so he's taking everything I've built up throughout life out of me.
Holy shit.
Hey, you can hear this comedy tomorrow night at Jones Beach.
You guys are fucking brutal.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
And then we got to sit now through this fucking audio of that first show.
Did you guys ever have a family reunion? Like a shower type thing?
No.
We're going to...
Never had a family reunion.
Hey, Rich, way to bring it up 2 days before Father's Day.
Yeah. You know, my father's dead, thank you.
What, you want to, freaking dig up his corpse and get him in a shower?
You know, him and his big fat Italian cock are gone.
Just right down the drain.
Dear old dad, right down the drain.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh,
I just remember it being like one of those big V8 cans.
So when your mom... When
you
your mom
be saying that. He wants everyone to know he has a big cock.
When your mom started...
I bet you this fucking does, too, guys.
Oh, you know he does.
When your mom started dating, you didn't say, we don't have to take a shower with him, too, do we?
Yes, that was it. Yeah, that's me and Sal.
Bro, your son's in the shower with me, Ro. Got a nice cock, Ro. He misses his father. Ro, I'm teaching him how to shower.
You know what? Come and think of it. I think Anthony only does impressions of people with big dicks. He does a great Milton Berle, too. You ever hear him?
I once made Nancy limp for a week. Yes.
All right, well. Did your treehouse have a shower in it?
All right, you know what?
I say we give it a couple of minutes.
Anthony had all the showers removed from his house.
This disc is an hour. I guarantee we don't get past 2 minutes.
2 minutes at most.
Actually,
I can't fucking listen to
it's
this.
It's actually not bad.
Shut the fuck up,
but
Jimmy.
It's actually not.
You're lying.
No, I'm not.
You're lying, sack of shit.
My old stuff is humiliating. Yours is just while you were a construction guy, a little overeager. I mean, it's not bad.
A little.
It's charming. Play it.
I am giggling at everything. I'm too loud. It's so embarrassing.
Want to float a bond before we play it?
Yeah, please. Yeah.
My problem is I'm
awful.
My problem is I'm still happy to do radio at this point.
You're not miserable yet?
No. Great.
Oh, your voice, too, is 18 octaves too high?
Yeah.
All right, well.
Let's go, baby.
I know we ain't making it up to Boo Boo Boo.
Let's get it going.
We have to stick together on this one.
I know we do.
I'll help fight, man. No problem.
Oh, I'll take these fuckers on.
Dude, it's over.
It's over. You two make me sick with their fucking top secret horseshit. Put that on, you two radio hacks when you were 13. Going woo, making noises and get the put this shit
awful.
On.
It's going to be like the 300.
Let's remind everyone. We're going to remind.
Look at this disclaimer. Do they do this shit when anybody is just like,
we're
going to
remind
I'm
people
there,
that
boom,
this,
boom,
is,
boom.
This is from 1994.
Okay.
Right.
No one cares.
Yeah, well,
fair
enough.
Care. No one cares.
This I want to hear. 18 years old.
Bring your own sound effects Saturday.
All right. Well, you can bring the crickets.
I got this one.
You motherfucker. Wow. I can't believe they are stalling their asses off playing really. This.
Hey, we just had to get to 11, man.
All right, put this thing on. I got to hear it.
Why don't we just, let's just be supportive. And
all right, we promise. All right, you know what, Jimmy, you're right.
Who's
Jimmy,
buying this shit?
Jimmy, he's right. Let's just enjoy it.
It's an older work, and it turned into...
Because you know what, we might really like it.
Well, I like Anthony. Yeah. First of all, Anthony, honest to God, out of all the people that do impressions, you're one of the best.
Oh, thank you.
One second.
And wait till you hear George Burns.
No, wait, when you start to...
Did you watch that show with Jeff Ross at all?
No, I didn't.
Hey, Bob, why didn't you do that show and show up as Brando in Apocalypse Now?
Hey, Anthony, when they start the tape, can you turn around like an impressionist and fix your hair?
And then I'll turn around and be George Burns.
Listen, no, Danny Gans.
You know what? He is one of the best impressionists ever.
He's very good.
These two guys, both of you, man, you can't be that bad. I bet you it's good.
You're
one of the greatest radio
acts
ever in history, man.
I'll tell you this much.
Let's just enjoy it.
This was the demo tape that got us our...
There you go. There you go. It was something.
Shows you how bad radio was back in 94.
God.
Who was deaf fucking listening to it?
All right, let's just enjoy it.
I'm ready to listen.
I promise to listen to it.
All right.
What happened to my sunglasses?
Throw it in. Oh, you can't see? No, you don't want to look.
What happened?
They're around. Give Opie a shade.
You don't want to look at anybody.
Fucking Kenny took them. I got to hide my eyes.
You don't.
All right, here we go.
Brother.
Oh, no. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Have fun.
I'm not going to look. I'm going to cover.
Fans pointing out the buttons.
Who's heard this?
Jimmy's heard a little bit.
It's actually,
Patrice has never
I wish it was worse.
Jimmy, shut up. It is worse.
I wish it was worse.
I think we were going to try to do it one day.
Yeah, try to do this every, 6 months.
I listened to it. I was in a car once listening to it, and then I had to pull over and...
You heard it?
I guess
a little bit of it, yeah.
Oh,
shit. You shut it off. But it wasn't that bad.
It's so bad.
No, wasn't that bad.
E-Rock, you want to make fun of us? Sit down.
If E-Rock makes fun of me, I'll have to kill him.
No, you
don't even want to get into because you know coming. It's Opie. It's Opie. Back selling a song.
No one's saying we just want
to. It's Opie the Rock Jock back selling a song, and he doesn't want. I know exactly what you're feeling here.
It's radio.
Dude. Was that Heart? Who was that?
I think that was Soul Asylum.
Oh, was it? Oh no.
You know, and I had a.
Oh no! This is so bad.
I had to make believe they were cool.
Yeah, that's it.
Let's hear it.
Oh fuck! This is awful. How did we get in this shit? Oh no!
Holy shit!
Long Island's best rock, WBAB Soul Asylum. Black Gold, Steve Miller, and the latest from...
They're already laughing.
Shit.
Look at Boss. Look at fucking Boss, that cocksucker.
Oh, my God.
He pointed at somebody, too. Soul Asylum.
Wow, you're getting a standing ovation out there. Holy shit.
It's fucking... Here's why everybody's laughing. Soul. It's just weird to hear you backsong a song.
Oh, my God. Oh, shut up.
That's not bad to say that was
so laughing.
Oh, my God. I haven't been under the bus in a long time.
Oh, God.
Rel on his hands. You should drink that.
I never thought I'd wish for another 30-day suspension. I'd like one to start immediately.
I want to hear Anthony Charming because he introduced Anthony.
Shut up.
I got dirt on all you motherfuckers, and I'll take it right to the bad part.
I agree.
Nice.
Let's go.
Black Gold, Steve Miller, and the latest from REM. What's the frequency, Kenneth, as you do the nighttime attitude at Copia Board. Thanks for checking out the program tonight. And we got another fine show planned for you guys tonight.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no.
Did you say fine?
Yeah, it's what?
Things were fine.
There's nothing left in this cup that he's drinking. Opie, he's fucking eating his cup. This motherfucker's like,
wait a minute. I'm gonna take a fake phone call.
Here's how you know it was an old show, because you said the word planned. Like there had been show prep on
it. He had like a brown bag with a sandwich that somebody prepared for him.
Yeah, you.
Oh, yo.
Idiot.
That's
stupid.
I was enjoying it, man. Shut the fuck up.
Actually, you were actually kind of smooth. Very smooth.
Don't make me bring up the glass dildos and we had a moment.
I already brought it up, nigga. No. I want to.
We had a moment, though. I was like, Patrice, what are you doing?
I know. I've had a lot of problems that, you know what, that this show has helped me with, and I love this, man.
There's nothing that could be brought up, though, that is as bad as hearing old audio. Like, I'm sure all you motherfuckers have shit from years ago that you're like, oh, God, I can't even listen to it.
Here comes the...
Oh, stop it, Bobby. You were fucking great forever.
Bobby, I wasn't sucking my dad's cock. If he's like,
I did not either.
That would have been more dignified than most of your material.
We lost your mic.
That would be more noble.
We lost your mic.
That would be more noble than your marshmallow-olio.
My jokes. You're talking about fucking sexual positions, you asshole.
It's cold out there, but warm in my belly.
I'm going to fucking re-break your leg.
It's all fun.
I know. Let them eat each other.
I know. Bobby couldn't listen to a tape from 7 days ago.
I know. Jesus Christ. After Torgasm, he canceled HBO.
All right, Joe.
That's our only saving grace, though, is they can't be around each other without laying into each other.
We really are fucking hyenas.
Oh, you are.
You know, we were actually eating the fucking gazelle when we started fighting with each other. Hey, assholes, there's enough to go around. You know, let's get back to Dick Sucker and High Pitch Henry.
Good focus, Bobo.
Thank you.
You guys got a rare opportunity.
Oh, God.
Praying mantis like eating each other.
All right, damn.
Oh, checking out the program tonight. And we got another fine show planned for you guys tonight.
Mm-hmm.
We got my pals Joe and Anthony from Rotgut live in the studio.
Is there a black girl in the
room? Good, man.
You have a black co-host?
People don't know who you are.
Do you have a black woman co-host? Did somebody just go, oh, shit, honey. We got ourselves a show, baby.
What? That was cool. Like, you agreed with him. Why shouldn't you agree with him?
Jimmy.
I'm sorry.
I am going to fucking smack you and leave I will leave a handprint.
Were you and Joe practicing in the car as you were driving there together?
Of course we were.
Hey, leave Benicio Del Toro hair alone.
Thank God we got Patrice in here today. He doesn't know when to shut up, so we'll get about 45 seconds.
Motherfuckers really try, but this is classic high school shit. Where when you're on it, you gotta push it onto somebody else and try.
Here we go.
I'm with you.
We're 32 seconds in.
How you doing, man? Good, man. Just in case people don't know who you are, yet.
the famous
authors of Gun Electric Shock OJ, which you're gonna do live on the show tonight.
That's right.
And you're gonna do other ditties.
Yeah, other wacky, kooky stuff, Obi.
Who's that stranger that walked in the studio?
I have to leave.
Why?
I have to leave.
Who was
from those? Had Casey Kasem already? Wait,
on your resume it says I do ditties.
No, he said he was going to do some wacky goofy stuff, but he was trying to describe what was happening.
Shut up, Jimmy.
Look, do you do Batman too?
This is so fucking awful to listen to. I can't fucking listen to this.
I know.
I'm gonna have to leave.
Hey, can we listen to that? Can we listen to that sassy black chick one more time?
No, there's no rewinding. There's no rewinding.
You don't like it now, but you know that right when you left the studio, you called your girlfriend. How was I? Did it sound good?
Was it good?
Hey, Bob, I want to hear some more.
Wait, but your intro should have been, you might recognize this guy if you had your heater fixed last week. Okay? You might recognize this guy if you called the fucking Culligan man.
If your bedroom is nice and cool and comfortable, you may recognize this guy.
Okay. Wow, Boss, a little angry.
Boss is Mount St. Helens. Yeah. It's been fucking building up and building up.
You just spit out a filling.
Why did a Buick pop out of his mouth?
Oh, shit. Oh, sorry, man.
Well, there you guys go.
No, I want to hear a little bit more. I don't want to miss wacky, kooky stuff if it was coming
Shut up.
They were titties.
They were titties.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Let me try to do it.
Some wacky cookie.
It's second nature. It's right there.
All right, let's go back to the tape. That's 13 years old.
All right.
Right.
Oh, God, help me.
That's better. We gave Eddie Vedder the idea to do that.
Yeah, there you go.
Was your brother dressed as a transvestite?
Sitting on the dock.
He sounded...
Yeah, you keep talking. Voss, keep chiming in, my friend.
All right.
I got no problems with Voss talking today.
You talk whatever you want.
Yes.
We only have to go to 11.
You're sweating.
That's what someone just said. You know, they heard Pearl Jam's version of Sitting on the Dock of the Bay, and they were expecting to hear the OJ version.
Oh, this is
so bad. He sounded like he was heavily sedated. All right, I need a ruling. I started
No.
Someone needs a ruling. We can vote.
Oh, no. We can vote. Look at Jimmy. Jimmy's so enthusiastic about this whole thing because you're a fucking cunt. Jimmy, you suck.
I've never seen him enthusiastic to do a radio show.
I know. Oh, look, we can vote.
Oh, I like voting.
Audience participation.
I like voting.
Oh, God. It is so, because you know why? Because we know what's coming, and it's just, it's so fucking bad.
I think it's not that bad so far. It's kind of entertaining.
No, it's not.
We're fucking with you because we think we have to, but this is actually pretty good.
No,
stop it.
It actually is.
And then Patrice puts on his poker face.
Honestly,
he's fucking sitting on pocket aces.
Oh, shit, I got aces.
You guys had a connection right off the bat. You can see it.
Shut the fuck up.
Yeah. All right, I need a ruling. I started a new bit yesterday. God. Celebrity Death Watch.
Right, yep.
All right, you might have heard this last night. Monday, Jessica Tandy, the old broad from Driving Miss Daisy, died. Yeah.
Hey, I'll take that contract. How old is she?
85.
Oh, please.
Anyways, I don't know about you, but I've always been under the... celebrities die in threes, basically.
Always.
Always, right? So it's the Celebrity Death Watch. I guarantee two more prominent celebrities will die before October 1st. So we're just waiting and watching. George Burns in the hospital the other day.
It was a close call. Very close call.
But he got out of it. Yeah. 98 years old. He has, like, his brain is swelling.
He pulled out.
And he pulled out of it. I was like, darn.
I always wanted to see.
Oh, Jesus George Christ.
Did the FCC come after you?
Darn.
I think you got 30 days.
You motherfucker.
If you two were famous back then, you would have been 2 and 3.
No, it wouldn't be 2 and 3. It'd be 2 and 3.
Gee Willikers, Robert.
Darn.
Celebrities die in three.
I can't fucking deal.
Anthony is hiding behind the mic.
I'm hiding. I'm laughing at every little fucking thing.
Why?
It doesn't matter.
Because you know why? He feels how much of an excited asshole he was.
So happy
not
to be there.
To talk, just
dude, this was my ticket out of construction.
You know what he
and
was
I thought if
was
I did
there?
Good at,
he was in the fucking studio with his hands up. Like he was on a roller coaster.
Yeah.
He was wheelchair. He ran the Kinko's the next day and got a resume.
You know what?
One day
listening to you or early radio is like watching Voss act.
No, disrespect.
Okay. But I mean, just like,
I'm so over fucking zealous. I like wanted to be there. I was happy to be there. I was so excited that this could lead to me doing radio
and not doing work anymore.
And listening to this, I wonder how it ever fucking happened. But I can't fucking listen to it. It is so painful.
You know what?
All right, we get it, you stalling motherfucker.
Fuck up.
You know what? Why don't we play the rest of the tape on stage at Jones Beach tomorrow night?
I would think we should probably play it. Wow. But how come time is going so fucking slow?
But you can go. You can go over time here. It doesn't matter.
No, there's new rules in place here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Out of it. I was like, darn. I always wanted to see George Burns singing that Extreme song.
Oh, no.
If you don't what you see here... Get the funk out.
But he never does that.
Very good.
Maybe now after he's bopped on the head. But I need a ruling. I got an obituary.
Oh,
Patrick
God.
O'Neill, 66.
Mm.
People are going, Patrick who? Now I said it has to be a prominent celebrity. This guy was... in Stepford Wives, 1975. Ooh. What do you think?
Don't look at me like
it's
that, Jimmy.
It's on the fence. Is he prominent
let me,
enough?
Let me see, Joe. What do you think?
I rule nay.
No. No.
I rule
nay. All right. So it's still one with two celebrities to go, 2 weeks from now.
Two to go.
Two to go. All right. Well, we're going to debut real fast a song from
Hot Gun. Who the fuck was doing talk radio back then? Like just children or
it's
y'all are
so
awful.
This wasn't even.
You should have been on 3 hours before y'all come on now, and y'all should be trashing
you.
Who are these two assholes? And who's this George Burns happy motherfucker?
Why? So you always wonder what it would be like if George Burns sang a song and then damn it, he did.
Shut up. Turn that song off, you douchebag.
Danny's fired.
Oh my God, right this now. Is God. So
do
awful.
Fired.
Do it right now.
Jeez.
What? All right. I don't know when the vocals kicking. If you don't like.
I think he wants to do it again.
No, I don't.
I'm trying to take the heat off.
Hey, we were on in the middle of the night.
Huh?
We were on in the middle of the night.
Right.
And the band with four? Oh. Motherfucker had to fly a pterodactyl to get that station.
Yeah,
wait, fly that was it? Got it. George Burns, there it is.
This is horrible.
Stand on your roof with aluminum bat and your ass away from an electrical storm. Face it to the left.
Broadcasting from Elm to Oak Street.
Wait, I think I got it. Darn.
You're listening to Opie and Anthony on 72.8. What?
72. Oh, well, we're going to debut.
Anthony, do you have any plugs? Yeah. I'll be fixing Tom's air conditioning on Saturday. I'll be signing at the appliance store.
I get a fucking nice
oh, boss break. Is now
he's
slaying.
On fire.
That's right.
Yeah, you know.
This is all built up over the years, and he can finally unload.
Someone said traveling virus back then. You say there must be mold in the heating duct.
I guess you're going to tell me to make my own egg sandwiches.
I just played a tape.
Well, we're going to debut real fast a song from Rod Gut about the Cuban refugees.
Right.
There was a Billy Joel made a tribute to the Bayman.
Right.
And we figured, you know, why not go to the other southern half of the states and make a little tribute to the Cuban boat people. Let's check it out on the Nighttime Attitude.
You guys don't get to hear that, really. Or maybe part of it, I think.
It was classic.
Set sail on a broken piñata, and I hope I can
parodies were my forte.
I've been out for about 15 minutes, and the water is up to my ass.
It was topical.
I'm leaving Cuba like my brother
did before. The whole audience is waving their arms, Opie, outside. I see lighters being lit. Yeah.
They're burning the studio down.
He'd like to make a donation.
Now I sail on a cheese enchilada.
Jesus. It's really bad.
It's really goddamn bad.
Yeah, nighttime attitude. Afternoon angry. Out of morning madness. Oh,
this is why Christy Brinkley left forever. Billy Joel.
Christy Brinkley. Christy.
Just say the chick.
Yeah, say the blonde chick. Christy.
Christy Brinkley.
Right into the song, he drove his car into a house.
That's right. Oh, Christy Green Donuts. Good recovery.
That was good, boss.
You were really needing a job, motherfucker.
You know, that I will never disagree
Dude,
with.
Dude, he was a fucking machine.
I Dancing needed this everything. I wanted a fucking job.
You were like Al Jolson, motherfucker.
When you were driving home, did you throw the Clippers out the window?
I thought that was it. Oh, I'm like, I'm in. I got a gig.
We're done. We're done. That's good.
No, we have a few minutes, folks.
A few minutes.
Did you ever do like
American Idol? Is of cashing our first welfare check.
Yeah, of course. So packed.
We're leaving
Castle. All right, is it going to go on all day?
Yeah, we're just embarrassed by El Presidente's beard. That hairy matted mess, you know he must have lice. My mother's beard's long, but at least she keeps it nice. Now I stare on her hand, eating pizza. It's not much, but it's all that I've got.
This is so touching. I feel like I'm in a shower at your house.
As much as I'll tease you, and I might even be sarcastic, a guy who does fucking heating. I'm okay. Sorry, what did you say, man?
I said it's so touching. I feel like I'm in a shower at his house.
I'm sorry.
Can you play the part where you go, well, that was fantastic.
It's coming up.
That was a great fucking thing you just said there.
It was, you know, the Cuban boat people. So Babaloo. Yeah.
That's the least. That's the least offensive. Why? He wasn't a comic, though. It was a fucking.
Oh, thanks.
But I'm saying, you're an air conditioning guy.
Hey.
I gotta be accurate. He was an air conditioning guy. I did a song parody. That's the most forgivable thing on this god awfulness.
Let me ask you a question.
While you were doing that, Bobby was practicing fucking chairs on stage.
Let me ask you a question.
No, let that sit. You get greedy, ass. All of a sudden, applause break. They really don't even like you, but now you got them on your side, and that's why they hate you again. Slurring asshole.
That's your question. Did you give him any, did you coach him in radio in any way?
Fuck no. Well, I taught him.
I learned
him
by watching.
I taught him all the bullshit stuff that happened, I guess. Yeah, but
apparently back then, this was good. I don't know why.
94.
I have no idea why.
What were they doing in radio? Well, let's 94.
I want to hear the end of the Babaloo because that song's over. The song's done.
Like that tape went out and they loved it.
Babaloo. In Boston.
Yeah.
Babaloo.
Gotta love that. Oh, Rot Gut on the Nighttime Attitude.
And on the eighth day, St. John's.
You really were a fucking serious dude at trying to not fix shit no more. In the background, you heard a faint.
Yes, it was the Ricky Ricardo laugh.
It was a faint mixing. It's just so ridiculous.
Lucy.
And he added his own echo because he couldn't afford an echo machine. So he went,
I recorded it in a duct.
Hey, is Kenny still around? I gotta change shirts.
Yeah, I was getting a little wet. Holy shit. Well, the song's over. It must be time for Ope to intro a song or something. This shit's been on much too much on me.
Push that button, fucker. Let's go, baby.
The Vincentian community in 1870.
Long Island's best rock, WBAB. Oh, we're live. 102.3 WBAB, Long Island. It's Opie in the Nighttime Attitude. Squeeze, of course, and Tempted. Sending that out to Sally in Levittown, faithful listener of the program. My choice.
You should have said the listener of the program.
Fuck you. Boss is on fire.
I think you should like that.
God damn.
Sally calling in again today. Sally's request for the day is.
I hope you're enjoying your last your last time on the show.
Why are you bringing Sally in? I hope Sally can do the Starbucks tour.
Hey, Sally, what's going on tonight?
Nothing.
That was Sally calling in.
What you guys doing? Nothing, Sally. What are you doing?
Can I hear some Squeeze?
I love Squeeze.
That's me.
Yeah.
My choice, though. I'm out of my mind tonight because I got Joe and Anthony from Rotgut, and these guys are, you guys are mental.
I know. That's right.
But thanks for stopping on by. I appreciate it.
No problem.
Anytime.
Pete DeLuso, Comac.
Wait a minute. Is that not they're mediocre at best.
He said crazy. Don't agree with anything.
Whoa.
Oh, it's Gabe Kaplan coming. Watch out. He's a fucking loon.
I'm out of my mind.
Whoa.
Sally's on the show.
Here comes Henry Ford.
I never thought it could be this bad.
Henry Fonda. Watch out. Henry Fonda's on the show. Whoa. You fucking maniac. You're a doodly crazy dandy doodly doodly.
I never fucking thought it could be this bad. I knew it was going to be this bad when this day came.
You are mental.
But this is so bad.
We got a crazy mental nutty show tonight. George Burns is going to stop by.
George Burns is singing extreme songs.
Hey, Sally.
Sally, yes.
Hey, Sally, what's going on? Hold on, I got another call. You guys still there? Yes, we're still here, Sally. I got to call you back. All right, Sally.
Too much energy in the room for me tonight.
Oh, shit. The phone line is lit up.
Holy shit.
Sally.
Oh, my God. This should have fucking been erased. I am soaked.
Wow. I'm not even kidding.
Isn't it really hot? Oh, it is so fucking hot.
Mental.
Get the Thorazine. He's mental. Where's the Haldol?
Watch out, baby.
Let's get back to the madness.
You know what that car crash was? It was a car crash really happening outside the studio at the time. Well, this show stinks. What's going on outside? Someone's dying. Holy shit, Sally! Jesus, Sally, are you okay?
I'm all right.
Oh, you're all right. This is Opie. Are you all right, Sally? I'm okay. Nothing happened.
As I just chuckle and laugh through the whole thing. Can you imagine if George Burns was driving that car?
Hey, look out.
In your bio, did you say mental? I was called mental back in the day.
And then before he got a job, that's what he do. When he just goes fix air conditioners, he uses those phrases now. Hey, man, your Freon is working. Your shit's going to work this fucking mental now. It's going to be fucking... crazily
mental cool air coming out of here.
Well, I would love to get back a little bit more. We're almost out of time.
Five minutes. Let's get mental, dude. Push it.
We're glad to do it. Pizza DeLuso, Comac.
Oh, jeez.
That would be Cliff. Yeah, no, that would be Cliff, Joe, and Greg. All we have to do is say it 10 times and we get a free pizza.
Are you serious?
They deliver it. They're going to deliver it right here.
All right, do it real fast. All right,
guys. That would be Pizza DeLuso, Pizza DeLuso, Pizza DeLuso, Pizza DeLuso, Pizza DeLuso. That's 5, 6. Pizza DeLuso, 7.
I said it, too.
Pizza DeLuso. Oh, so that's 10.
We're up to 12. That's a pie and a half.
All right. So you did have plugs that day.
Yeah.
And now he reads them like, oh, boy. All right. Well, let's get through
it. Vegas.
Shit. This motherfucker had a pocket full of taps that he just banged around his shoes. And they wore out every show.
Stop. He had a pocket full of sand put on the console.
Soft shoe. Hello, my baby. Hello, my honey.
It sure looked lovely, Nick Shirley.
Over-eager fucking whore.
Poland Springs, hey. Poland Springs, Poland Springs.
Let's get a listener in.
Hi,
here.
Sally's calling.
Sally.
Pat in Jersey. Pat, what's up?
Hey, I love you. Love you. Love the show. And my mouth just went retarded. Perfect. I was wondering if you guys ever realized the excitement in Opie's voice sounds really, really close to the Susan Waldman excitement.
Oh, my God. George Burns is singing extreme. Oh, goodness gracious.
This is pretty interesting from Jeremy in Jersey. Jeremy!
What's up, guys?
Hey.
Hey, Opie, how do you like Point Last Friday now?
Fuck point, you, Jeremy.
Point Last Friday. It stinks. I hate it.
Hey, it's not fun being on this side.
Oh, here we go.
and a half.
So all right,
Joe,
all right.
Cliff, get in your van and start down here. I want one with everything on it.
Great.
Thank you.
My boss is going to love that one. That was about $1,000 worth of advertisement. Yeah. Thanks, guys. I appreciate
your
it.
Show.
All right. Hey, we have Sam Houston in the studio
you
tonight.
You just gave away $1.30 worth of advertising.
I know.
Those fuckers are laughing too hard.
Oh, shit.
Our fifth caller. Sally.
Sally, your call is 1 through 6.
Oh, God.
And now for a free
caller win. Sally, you're only the third caller. All right, I'll call back in about 3 minutes. I'll be the fifth.
Oh, fuck.
Wait, I think we have Sally on the phone again.
Fucker, Voss. The beauty of Voss, I'll get the call after the show. You know, I'm just kidding.
You're not mad, are you?
You're mad, right? Are you? Oh, I'm gonna tear down some walls right now. Hey, I figured I'd join in because the rest of the guys are going at you pretty hard.
But you guys, right? You're good now.
Oh. See, Jimmy knows. Thank you, Jimmy.
Oh, this fucking worm. He'll be on the phone before he fucking pulls out of the parking garage. Shut up, nervous. Okay. And I'll get the same call. He's not mad.
And I'll turn on the radio and hopefully hear some rock gut.
Oh, fuck you.
Stupid Voss is going to sell CDs after this.
Fucking bad for you to do this.
Hey,
you cannot bring in what he's going to fucking do after
this. No, really?
Yes, Jesus. You can.
Is he going to start with me first? Because he thinks we're both in the same trouble. And I'm like, I'm going to be like,
oh, I'm in trouble all of a sudden.
He's going to lord it, Jesus. I said, we were joking.
You think it was bad?
Then he's going to go up to the show.
Fan? You think he's...
They're going to take me off the tour.
Was it bad that I sold my DVDs? I mean, they wanted them. They were asking.
Fucking, you're not supposed to go with them. That is just... He switched with a juggler, man.
That was the right move, though.
I learned a trick or two.
You got to deflect, man.
That's what this thing is going to do, you fucking puppy. All right.
This is bad. We're going to tap out. We're going to tap out.
Oh, listen who's talking. The guy that gets bombs and fires on the road, he does damage control before he gets home. You know what happened to me in Ohio? how the fuck would I know what happened to you in Ohio?
I don't call them and say, listen, as I'm getting fired right now, did I do wrong?
Well, how did this turn on me? We got a good tape going. You fucking...
That's why I knew he was going to do it.
Just in case anyone's wondering out there, this is the brilliance of me. Thank you.
I just came in the last minute.
Boss, that's why I got so mad at these things, because you've got to talk about
perfect
what a
diversion.
Little worm you are. Let him go. Fucking pussy. Erase his number so you can't call and apologize.
All right, let's...
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Oh, man. That was so fucking wrong.
No, he'll walk to the elevator and we'll go, that was fun, right?
Oh, look.
All right. Fucking slave eye motherfucker. Just say your jokes and... I knew that.
I got him under control now.
Nigga, that's
technique. Patricia's legitimately fucking angry.
Nigga, I've been
this
doing this for
douchebag.
Fucking years before comedy. That was DEFCON 12. That was Mushroom Cloud. He said, this is going to stop right now. You're going to call me later apologizing. And then what that does is scare us into thinking any, like, little pussy-ass shit that we all do, like, hey, Ope, you know, am I still going to be on the radio? Now we got to slow down. Because now Ope can look at you fucking because of you. Ope can give the eye like, oh, there's a lot of shit that you did too there, Patricio, buddy.
All right, here we go.
We've had some heart to heart. Don't let me. Fucking boss, man.
Now that we calmed you fuckers down, I'm on the push play again. The speeding frenzy.
You better keep it going, too, you punk motherfucker.
Yeah.
Play that horse shit from 1994.
Well, I hope I'm as good as Dennis Wolfberg.
You play it.
Hey, you really haven't come very far. 15 years ago, it was rot gut. Now it's fat gut.
Oh, shit. Point left Friday. Feel free to point to Patrice.
He's pointing?
Why is Bobby pointing?
Please, Bob, if I had two heads, I would have been looking at you, too.
You, he's fatter than me. That's why I'm pointing.
No, he's also taller than you.
If you put the relative size, you're 4'8". But first of all, 6'4".
Both of you.
We're reverse. You're 4'6".
At least at one point.
First of all, Fryer hack.
Never been in shape and always been A shape. I had abs at one point.
Oh, yeah. It's called a fetus.
Now you are abs. Wait, now you are abs. You're absolutely fat. You're an absolute mess. You're a lot of abs. You are abnormal.
Abundant. You know, Voss can't come up with a fucking idiot.
No, he can't.
There's no, he'll say something with AP in it. Adaption.
What?
Oh, fuck.
Jesus.
Norton lost a little weight, and all of a sudden he's a fucking an exercise expert. He still has a little fat stomach, too, and I don't like it.
Wow, you're opening your seltzer. It's exploding all over your face. Reminds you of those showers, doesn't it?
That's why he drinks seltzer.
Yes.
Obi, why do you shake it so hard? And who opens it right next to their eye?
Why do you have soap and drink seltzer at the same time?
Oh, you motherfucker. Oh, shit.
Are you leaning over? Is that how you're shaped?
He's shaped like a lane.
He's shaped like in a parenthesis.
No one even knows. It's not like a fucking a comma, you fucking dumb.
You are such a shithead. A parenthesis. Fucking idiot.
Don't try punctuation jokes.
Absolutely. Please.
Keep going, boys. Keep out of this. Keep going, boys. They're eating each other.
I
love it. Fighting over the carcass and they forget about the carcass.
You
got a carcass in front of you when you're out there eating each other's legs. Fuckers.
Oh, shit.
All
right, I guess we've done it.
Let's hear a little bit.
I said a couple more minutes. Just to give the XM or something.
Shut up, Jimmy.
Hey, we have Sam Kinison in the studio tonight, too.
Oh,
my God.
I agree. Enough.
How big are you guys?
What? Wow, look, it's five after.
Sam Kinison?
That's amazing. How'd you get him in the studio?
Absolutely. And how did you get his body?
I know.
It wasn't that good.
I agree.
All right, well.
I want to hear Kinison. If Kinison was in the studio.
We're going to have to hide again.
All right, I'm
why?
Fine.
Not us.
To hide again. Because it's awful. Because first of all.
Sam's in the studio.
Let me say another thing. I have another thing I have to preface. I had been out at a gig the night before, so I was singing, and my voice was shot, so I couldn't really do a good impression.
You didn't have
that
to.
Day.
Like, he was in the studio.
You had another person come in. That the heat's off you.
I did a much better Kinison impression on Howard's show.
Oh.
This one.
Still see
us, oh, God.
Painful.
Unless you can shut the sun off, your embarrassment isn't going away.
Right. Unless you can shut the sun off.
Motherfuckers.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. All right. Hey, we have Sam Kinison in the studio tonight, too.
Sam. Hey, old man. How you doing, bud?
Pretty good.
Yeah, we're hanging out with the guys tonight, having a good time.
From Rotgut?
Yeah, I'm hoping that pizza comes down. I'm losing a little weight being dead.
I got nothing. Hey, Sam, what do you think of O.J. Simpson?
Oh, guilty as sin. I was talking to Nicole and her waiter friend.
Oh my.
Yeah, she said he came up, looked pretty angry, stuck a knife in her. You know, the whole deal.
Okay. Very good.
Wait.
Speaking of which, I think it's time to do...
Jesus Christ. Oh, you suck.
That was so incredibly bad.
What? That was just...
But I can't even come out.
It made me sick. Oh, how do you get a job at that?
My voice was shot.
That was a great one. Like who? Bud Dwyer? That was a good impression of Fred Kinison. That was his cousin.
That was awful.
Oh, this is a nice hot topic.
Oh, I can't come out. I can't come out yet.
Why?
I
come on, Sam. Why not?
Oh, man.
Come on, Sam. Who's that bad?
Come on, Sam. After that one, you took the... Holy, you took the gas out of Greg after that one.
Oh!
I understand. I couldn't do that part because my voice was very strong. You could hear it when I'm talking. It's cracking a lot.
I'll do it for you. Oh, can I get a job? Oh, me. I need a job. Oh.
All right, here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Oh, please.
Speaking of which, I think it's time to do Gonna Electric Shock OJ live on the Nighttime Attitude. It's Rot Gut. Check this out.
Los Angeles jail, and that judge won't let me post my bail. Now this could be the end of me, 'cause California's got that death penalty. They gone electric shock, OJ.
Fallon Sandler.
Cook my behind like a chicken croquet. Take on electric shock, OJ. Toast my behind.
Got me out of radio. On the radio. Fuck, I can't even talk.
Nicole, I really love that girl. But she had the worst luck in the world. I was only cleaning my knife. I accidentally stabbed her 36 times. Take on electric shock, OJ. Cook my behind like a cherry flambé.
You're listening to the Nighttime Attitude.
Take on electric shock, OJ.
Well, the Nighttime Attitude, we behind. Just... We're wacky. Darn, we're wacky. Sally, Sally, you're listening to the Nighttime
Looks
Attitude,
like
Sally.
I'm a guilty man.
Sam, you want to chime in?
Now I'm going to have to love my hand. What was worse would make me flip my lid. I hear Michael Jackson is watching my kids. Why don't they cut me some slack?
Hold on, we have Top of the Town on the phone. I think they want to hire you. Hold on, Fast Eddie's calling. I think we got you a gig here.
They be warming up that electrical chair. They gone electric shot, OJ. Press my behind like a sound of fillet.
I want to know.
They gone electric shot, OJ. My
I used to work.
Who that hurts? Give me a call. Give me the hell out of here. I was in Chicago. I was
with
you.
Race Stevens. It's like the end of the streak.
Hold on. He's walking on hot coals now. As he does
that. OJ.
Boy, I do that whistle better than Eddie Vedder.
Bravo.
You're listening to Nighttime Attitude.
You did whistle better than Eddie. You wanted out.
You really I wanted you really out. Did.
Fuck me. I've never heard that like that. He wanted out.
Fucking Nipsey Russell. I really didn't want to work.
God bless Opie for getting this motherfucker out.
How bad was your day job? Was your boss just rape you in the end?
Made him take showers.
That's why he did air conditioning, not plumbing.
Teaching me to shower.
Hey, since Torgasm, what do you miss most except your neck?
This guy second saved that one.
I actually think he has it on paper.
Where the fuck did that come from?
Slurping G.
Oh my God.
He gets nervous. He picks up food. That's the problem.
Bobby, don't put that apple in your mouth. They'll think we're roasting you.
Holy shit.
Let him go, man. Let him go.
Continue, boys.
Oh, shit.
Wow, we really do turn on each other.
Hey,
really just a bunch of savages.
Damn.
It's just bad.
It is, man.
It's just bad. There's not one friend in here.
Oh.
All right, back
Joe,
to, back to Sam.
Bobby,
this.
You're listening to Daytime Attitude.
You always gotta get greedy, don't
just
always.
Let him. It was kind of funny there, Orson Welles. Yeah. Let him go. Let him just go.
He is like those click clacks.
And you look like one.
Oh, you got it. You got it. You're lucky you got the laugh.
Hey, everyone knows that Voss is hilarious, but I've never heard him slay with such confidence on the radio.
Voss, oh, yeah.
And you try to take it away? Oh, yeah.
Jesus.
I learned something about you today, motherfucker.
Evil Opie, the fucking comedy block.
That was a mushroom.
Your career started off as a comedy block. You wanted to bring it right back.
He really launched
the nuclear missile.
Oh, he really did. That was an IED, nigga.
It was called for.
Yeah.
It was acceptable.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Because it gave us a chance to attack him a little bit for his worminess, which had to come out sooner or later.
It had to be addressed. You really are.
Yeah. Here we go.
Oh, man.
We're hanging out with Rod Gutt on the Nighttime Attitude. They got a song about the guy that crashed into the White House.
You know what? It would be faster if you named the things they didn't have songs for. It happened. We sing about it.
You are so fucking right.
Oh, we got a song about the crocodile hunter. Got a song about the space shuttle.
If I hadn't gotten a job,
there would have been songs about that shit. We had Amy Fisher, Joey Buttafuoco songs. Fucking John Wayne Bobbitt songs. You gotta realize it was all the time all that shit was happening. Anything that would happen, I'd write a fucking song parody about it and send it out to radio stations hoping to get the fuck out of it.
They even did a Judge Ito song.
Yes, I had a Judge Ito fucking song.
I got a Clarence Thomas song too.
Mike Tyson,
Buster Douglas song?
That was a little before that.
Mike Tyson got punched in the mouth, and he fell and looked like he was down south. Fucking awful motherfucker. And then in the back he'll be like, absolutely, doing a Mike Tyson fadeaway. Jesus Christ.
He rhymes like a prisoner.
He really is old Mr. Rusty Knuckles, the old blues time Rusty Knuckles, here on Nighttime. Attitude with Rusty Knuckles.
The night before, did your mom go, come on, guys, quit practicing. It's time for dinner. You were down in your basement.
No, they were in the shower.
Fucking Rupert Anthony.
He was practicing in the shower, using his father's cock as a microphone. Wait, we're getting away from the point at hand here.
Did you notice that you lose one sock in the dryer? Oh, shit, that's...
Well, you do this well. Did you work the door at his studio then?
Yeah, here we are practicing. Yeah.
Mom! I have to do this now. Mom, please stop calling me. I ain't gonna lie to you. All of this shit, you can hear. It's not desperation. He wants out.
He wants out.
That fucker wanted. You had a plan, nigga, to get the fuck out.
I had to. I would be homeless. I couldn't work anymore. I guess we should stop right here.
I say give him a couple more minutes just for the satellite fans who stuck by us.
Shut up, Jimmy.
Yeah. Fucking Jimmy.
That is true.
Jimmy does have a point.
You got to give him a little more.
It's been a month.
They want to go home. They want to start their
week. You guys want to go home or you want more? You want to hear another couple minutes? Look at the nodding, friendly heads.
Look at the... Hey, when you got to
look
work...
Look at the sea Kyles
when you got
out
to
there.
Somebody's house, did you slide in with your tool belt like Tom Cruise and start breaking...
Fucking Voss.
Wow.
Where have you been for a year?
Don't fucking take away 8 years of me slamming and killing fuckers in here. No.
Don't keep
on adding on years so all of a sudden I'm in that studio in Long Island with you. Where have you been for 10 years?
I didn't realize, I never caught because we never smashed him. That motherfucker got a tool belt full of acid.
When his back is in the corner, it's over. It's fucking over.
Fuck that motherfucker's a survivor.
It's either that or I need a shower. I'm
scratching claw.
Hello, Anthony. We have the good rats on the phone right now.
I say we give a couple more minutes, man. For what? I say for these people, they deserve a show.
What an overeager fucking ass.
Hey, Sally, if Sally's listening, can you call?
What do you mean if? She has to be, or they wouldn't be on the air.
I hate the overeagerness, the want, the need.
I would too. I hear it.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah.
Like
fucking
everything
hear it.
Upset. I just had a laugh. Like you could be introing a record, and I'm like,
yeah.
Now you know how we feel. deal.
Yeah, no, they need to snail you.
Don't these motherfuckers.
Oh, shit.
No. Wow, did he fucking nail Opie.
Oh, my God.
I said everything Opie said, I felt like I had a laugh at him. He goes, now you know how we feel.
Don't say we. Not Brad.
Wait, and that's
I.
The
don't love all of us. Is he a fucking Monday morning?
Let me tell you something. You see that one? That's the one he's going to call and apologize.
I didn't really mean that.
Oh, Jesus. This is going to cost me another round of golf.
Fuck you.
He does feel guilty, and he pays for the golf. Yes, it's true.
He came out to my course. That's what you do. That's called. It's like a wedding gift. It's like you give a gift.
These guys keep bringing up the Eager thing. They have no idea they went through the Eager stage on this fucking show with you and I.
Oh, that's true.
I say we went through the Eager stage.
But they had already been, you know, pros on.
Now, some of us were still roofing.
Yeah. Fuckers. E-Rock should find the first time you fucking
I killed her the first time. I remember the lady was standing there with electric.
Your voice.
No, that fucking lady was standing with electric.
When did it change?
The light. And I smashed a guy from Brazil. The first time in your studio, this guy from Brazil.
I remember the days I would go, okay, now you can talk.
This validation needed motherfucker.
No, I'm just saying I remember the first time. I walked you in, bitch, the first time you came here.
He tried to walk me in like it was the scene in Goodfellas where you go through the kitchen.
Yeah.
Like, hey, meet the new nigger I found. Fuck you, bitch.
All right, I'm telling you, I introduced him as a doorman. I go, this guy can see the motherfucker like nobody else sees him. See, he loves Dennis Wolfberg, so don't trash Dennis.
See, I know how these guys think.
Oh, I know.
See, it was like that Pesci movie, except with Voss, it was Dumbfellas.
All right, back to the
All right.
You guys only get another minute.
All right.
That kook.
That we're going to debut in a few that you're going to love. That's and if Frank you got Porter. Something to add to the program tonight, give us a call. 955-WBA-BAY.
Hell, sometimes it's
going to make not this.
Oh, another parody.
Real
102% Long Island. We're WBAB Babylon, WHFM Southampton. Thanking everyone in Hop Hog for showing the world they love rock and roll.
These motherfuckers want this Opie back. He's repping Long Island, baby.
When he said Hop Hog, did you jump over your brother to get to your dad's cock?
2%.
0% dignity.
Why didn't you just go Captain's Log?
Dave from Manhattan. 10 more minutes and Voss will be buying Opie a trip to the Bunny Ranch.
If you buy the Elmhurst tanks right now.
Shut up. 102%. Did you do one of the fists on your chest like Long Island, bitch?
Strong Island.
All the way from Bayshore to Patchogue.
Looks like you've done a lot of accurate. My friend.
This is WIROC radio.
Dude, 100% is good. 102% is even that much better.
Yo, and everyone that was actually King's Park.
That was Long Island, bitches.
The 2% was actually Anthony when he was on the show.
Maybe it's the milk you should start drinking.
Oh, yeah, my buddy Anthony! Oh, Jesus.
He hit you like the punching bag you shaped like.
Yeah! This is vicious.
Oh, man.
Hey, you know what happens? When one guy turns, you guys all step back.
He almost gave you an uppercut, but there was no chin to hit.
Leave King Kong and Batman alone.
Uppercut to Bobby. Uppercut to Bobby is a good cut of steak.
What's a bad cut of steak? That's like without the eyes.
Woo!
He hit you like the punching bag in your steak. Oh, God. This changes in a fucking second, doesn't it? I had you right in a fucking
fucking a triangle choke.
Ultimate fight.
And you swept right out.
It really is. We should end it before some real shit swordplay. Well, fuck you, motherfucker. What about you eating shit?
Monday
through
Friday.
You can get E. coli from that shit. All serious. Everybody get serious.
Why is he so safe all of a sudden?
Who?
Jimmy hasn't taken a punch yet.
No.
I take him.
Jimmy gets him.
Yeah.
We give it to him all the time.
We were smashing his stomach the other night.
Help us out a little bit. Jesus.
Because
there's a bigger plate of mashed potatoes here than him. Okay? All right. He came with butter and bread and history.
Right. He said it without spitting. Can you try that,
Jesus? But his pronunciation is perfect today.
Hey, you should change your name to Carb Kelly. Carb Kelly.
This is a hot one.
It's a hot one. Push that fucking button open.
Sally?
Wait, Sally? What was that noise again? That's the sound of Carmen from Bob Gets In It.
Sorry, Bob, but I have a job to protect.
I have a mortgage to pay.
Oh, I mean, geez. I'm taking you out to dinner. It's the same thing.
Holy shit! I want to leave because the turn is vicious.
It's a bad
one. I'm going to wait it out, though, because I know Voss is going to be the one to fuck it up.
I'm not going
to
fuck it up. Every time he walks in the room, he hits bonus.
There you go.
Thank you. I knew you were going to do it. You greedy asshole.
You
got too excited.
Yeah, you
were. You fucked up on every time.
Calm down. You don't stutter when you eat, do you?
And he's right back in. He's right back in. Boss does not stop.
Fucking ruthless.
On Bobby's watch, there's no numbers. There's pictures of food.
No.
And
no.
He's right back out.
That's pretty good.
That's pretty good.
Nah.
No.
What time is it?
Nah.
What time is it? 10 after pie.
All right, here we go. We're back. All right, we're back. Here we go.
What time is it? Chicken.
This fucking motherfucker with stretch marks on his titty.
All right, I'll meet you at 10:30 for dinner.
This cocksucker.
Oh, shit.
Oh, Jesus.
Shit. Oh.
What doors take the most oil to get in?
That was all right.
Any ones your hair goes through.
All right, I guess we've done our job today.
Yeah.
I think wait a minute. Drift.
I just fucking realized, Autos. You're right. Where the fuck have you been? I forgot he was here.
We all did. You're sitting in front of him, Fesso.
We thought you were his dummy, but his dummy's in shape. We'd fuck his dummy.
You guys
fucking
go on,
asshole.
No, you should go on tour together, Otto and Jupiter.
Otto and Jupiter.
Oh, you know what?
I really want you to fight back, but it's not. You guys are on fire. Because I can see it in your eyes. You got like five more in the back just waiting to come out like automatic weapons.
Otto, this gets vicious on you, motherfucker.
I like how you fucking two cocks are quiet right up, didn't you? It was your 2%, you douchebag.
All you did was throw two. All you did was drop two mushrooms, and it was done.
Right. That's it.
It was fucking
That's
done.
It. Wow. Okay, right. Lord of the Flies, you motherfuckers. We should end on an up note. So we'll
say so.
Yeah.
Yo, B.A.B.
Hey, kiddo, how you doing?
Nicky J.
Oh, no, we should end before
whoa,
this.
Whoa. I want to hear Nicky J.
No.
We got to hear that.
No.
That sounds fun.
We should hear it.
What I'm about to say will be 20 minutes.
It sounds mental. Let's hear it.
I've heard it. It's not.
It sounds like it's going to be crazy and just nuts.
And don't forget, Monday, Sally will be in studio. Sally.
I say you
I know that comes in.
I need to rest any goddamn way.
I know that comes into play.
I say a second. You let it go.
Any leverage I gained?
Oh, I say it's worth it.
I am done. I think you're right. Let's end on an up note. Bobby's weight.
Oh. You notice this room is tilting to this side.
Joe.
You know what? Some of these chuggy basses, they can only take so much of the fat jokes themselves. Thank you. Thank you very much.
It does look like a Wiz Waldo of Bobby Kelly's out there.
I know. It's like...
Where's Walrus?
If they were making a... It's like a casting call for the Bobby Kelly story.
You motherfuckers.
While we did Camden, the aquarium came back for him.
Jesus Christ.
Listen to me.
Sally? Goes, that wasn't bad. You auditioned Sally? For Sally? Jack Parr? Jesus Christ. Oh, fuck.
All right, well.
I say we give it another couple minutes and then we go. Cause we wrap it up.
EJ!
Yeah, what's happening?
The mayor of Montauk. How are you, bro?
Oh, cool. You're doing political.
What do you think about the OJ now, man? The DNA came in and said his blood is true.
His blood is true?
Yeah. His blood.
What do you mean his blood is true?
Well, they said with the DNA...
Right.
They said it's his blood that was on the path of his house there. You better find some good drugs, OJ. Don't pull yourself boys going up your poop tube.
Wait, what was that line again?
Don't fool yourself boys going up your poop tube. Hey, tell Rocco, send me a piece of pizza when he comes out this weekend.
Who's Rocco?
Your buddy's there, right? They ordered a pizza.
Hey, it's Rocco's. Well, that would be Rotgut, but close enough, bro. You want to sing a song tonight,
Andy.
Buddy? Well, how about a little Zeppelin? Rotgut wants to play while you sing.
Okay, go, man, go.
All right, which one do you want to sing? Good times, bad times?
Yeah, there you go.
All right, whenever you're ready, bro.
Okay. Go, man, go. In my days of my youth, I was told what it means to be a man. Now, five times now, you know I have my share. When a woman comes around again, I don't seem to care. Boo, 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 boo.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mickey J.
Yeah.
Wait.
Yeah, I don't know. It was something.
I want to hear a little more.
Him. Nah, he would just say that when he called.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wait, he would say it. Was that you?
What an instigator.
No, that was Mickey J.
Oh, what an instigator. I've had this whole demo recut. I'm not stupid.
Oh, he cut out all of his boo-boo-boos. I say another sec. He cut his what out?
Mickey J was a...
what? No, he cut out his boo-boo-boos?
No, I didn't.
Why does Steve like Betty Davis?
I don't know.
What? We've been making fun of him for a week and we didn't come up with the Betty Davis line.
And wait a minute. Speaking of people that should cut out boo boo boos, where's Danny?
Holy shit.
Yeah, he decided to cut his... I don't know.
He went to trim his eyebrows, and the trimmer wasn't set right,
holy
so he cut
Jesus.
It off. Yeah, I whacked my whole eye. I whacked one eyebrow off because I wasn't paying attention to how low the trimmer was set, and then the other one was full, and then I had no eyebrow and a full eyebrow, so I just whacked the other one off.
Is that what made you wear a high water shirt?
Yes. Yes.
Jesus, it's almost a fucking blouse.
Well, I do have a history of wearing blouses.
It's an altar
you know
top.
I got you know what? Hold on, boss. Hey, Anthony, write a parody about his eyebrows.
Do this, Sam Kinison.
He got some eyebrows. Now he don't. Jesus Christ.
Lucy.
Holy shit.
Yeah, yeah. Well, they're coming back in.
No, they're not.
No, they're not.
They're really gradually. Not.
Bob, oh, God. That was brutal.
I said one more second.
One more?
Yeah, one more second. I said
Mickey J was drunk from Montauk and ended up
dying.
Drowning, yeah. That guy's dead now. He's dead. Hope you're... You know what? This is
Jethro Tull.
I don't think we've ever made it this far.
I think this is officially the furthest we've gotten into this, I think.
We've tried like six or seven times before this.
WBAB, the 70s best rock.
I should start talking like a DJ, man.
Jethro Tull.
You've
been doing it for 6 years.
Jesus, fuck, what do you mean?
A DJ, you mean boss, a dumb Jew?
You should have just done successful in that statement.
That motherfucker has been like 112, wow, attitude.
That's a good one.
Painful.
Otto, what are you doing? Dreaming of fucking George? What's you with the? He's just looking in the distance like, I miss George. I wonder what he's, what kind of sandwiches he's eating without me. Fucking, what are you doing?
Why didn't you bring George? You were scared Bobby would eat him.
Oh, Anthony would try to fucking suck his cock.
Come on, George, let's go to the sink.
I'm going to teach you what my dad taught me, son. It's called the fountain.
It's coming in too many times. Everyone's saying that we miss Voss saying altar top.
Oh, I said that?
Did you?
I don't know.
Might have.
Well, the H is silent. So, no. Yeah, sure.
How did that... This was weird.
It's Opie in the Nighttime Attitude. Just want to remind you quickly, tomorrow is Friday, and we're still looking for your suggestions for the perfect lunch hour, the Friday thematic perfect lunch hour. Tomorrow's topic, songs about school. You can fax your suggestions at 422-1023.
Okay, Sally.
He's just shorting that whole speech to help. Any listeners out there, help?
Fax your help to,
Fax your help to,
Oh, you can call in your help,
And don't forget, tomorrow we have landscapers coming in that do magic tricks.
And don't forget, Subway Worker Friday.
Next week we'll have a juggling painter.
Damn it, Bobby, why did you have to mention Subway?
I know. The one thing you can't get on.
What?
What does that mean?
You're too big.
Man.
The Subway.
Opie, can we end this before? There's no Sally.
They're telling us we have to go.
Who is it? Who's telling you? Sally.
A good show. Just the imaginary person has told us we have to get out of here.
And don't forget, this weekend we'll be at the. This weekend we'll be at the Rainy Night House.
What?
Those are all Long Island clubs.
Nobody and in the studio that. Live tonight, I mean, they've been doing so much cool stuff for my show, I thought I owed it to them to bring them in live. It's Rotka.
Thank you very much.
We got someone called in before and requested a reggae song. We don't know many.
All right.
We know Turkey one voice. Reggae song. It's a pale reggae song. Well, very pale. Give it a whirl. Let's check it out.
Then we have to leave.
And Tuesday, Bob Nelson will be calling in.
It's a story of a lovely lady who was bringing
the crowd.
There was such a lovely girl. All of them had hair of black. Just like their mama. The youngest one in dreadlocks. The story of a man named Brady. Who was busy with three boys?
Sound like Peter Tosh on
three
boys.
Very busy three boys. There were four men living all together.
Like a Jamaican with a hearing problem.
And they all get stoned. The Brady Blunt.
A little far to go.
The Brady Blunt.
Doctor, we became the Brady Blunt.
Jeff Norris was in the car going, beautiful. I could do this.
Hey, if you got something to add to the program tonight, 955
help.
WBAB. By the way, I got a surprise. We're going to end this show in style
again,
tonight. That's
help.
All I can say because someone else just called up.
Anything at all.
Call out the cat. Anybody out there? Help.
All right, that's good. That's a very good hint, by the way.
Help.
Why the Brady Blunts?
Shut up, Jimmy.
What the Brady Blunts?
Shut up.
Unfunny cunts.
He really did.
Wow.
He really did. That was the apology call too. We also apologize for that one. Just went.
Jimmy, what was the a chunky monkey ice cream flavor that you had?
Oh, what? When I was just starting out, I said that in Connecticut, that they were very ritzy and they wouldn't eat chunky monkey. They would eat obese primate.
And then you said,
I just wanted to feel how it felt.
No, and then you said, Mr. Levy, can I give you a ride home now? Levy was the beginning of Norton's evolution of I'll hold on to him career.
If you had hands that worked, you would too. Get those turtle feet away from me. Fucking doll hands.
All right, let's.
He really does have spider monkey hands.
He really does.
Give him tape a mic to his little stupid hands.
Those hands should be throwing his own shit.
At least my hands knew how to wash my own body when I was a kid.
That's it.
At least I would have had to teach my hands how to wash myself.
Now what are they going to learn to write?
Listen, we really do have to go.
My throat hurts from laughing.
We have to go. They're gonna shut us off. They're gonna play about 20 minutes of commercials and then start up Ron and Fez.
That was
right. Right? 11:40. We have to be off the air. Yeah.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wow, what a great first show. Hopefully we can
Jimmy,
keep it up
a little something
for another day. Oh, Jimmy's gonna show his ass.
They're liking your ass, Jimmy.
Yeah, who doesn't? So hairless.
Well, Anthony saw his ass and wants to take a shower.
Well, I know what Dad saw. A hairless little ass like Jimmy has.
Guys, thank you for the support.
Yeah,
we really appreciate
guys,
it.
Very much.
We'll see everyone at Jones Beach. All these guys that just killed last fuck since 6 o'clock this morning.
Yep.
We'll be at Jones Beach tomorrow. Tickets still available.
Yes.
You can walk up and get a ticket tomorrow, definitely. It's
going
to start
fun.
With the tailgating, the owner. You know the deal. I mean, we're talking to the faithful listeners now. They get, they understand. Thanks, guys.
Also, next week, I'm in Kalamazoo at the Laughing Post.
All right.
Kalamazoo.
Kalamazoo, Michigan, next week.
Cool. All right. Everyone, they're leaving. We're leaving. We'll see you guys tomorrow.
All right. Great. All right. Take care, guys.
Yes. Yeah, cool. Thank you, sir.
What a great welcome back from the fans.
Cool.
Coming in here.
I'm fucking exhausted from laughing so hard.
That was like the you guys seem to be reborn.
That was like a baptism.
I feel that's
officially now behind me.
Yeah.
I've dreaded that moment for so many years, having all of you guys.
We only did.
Oh, I know. Shut up.
All right. We only did a quarter of the team.
Oh, God. Jesus, man.
Yeah. And we ain't doing it anytime soon.
Well,
fuck you.
I gotta go.
Oh, Voss. My phone is already ringing from Voss.
Thank you so much, man.
Voss is text messaging from the other room.
Right.
Okay. I do laugh with stuff you say. Yeah, we gotta go. I know. Fans all freaking out. Shut up, you big poker winner.
Bobby. Rich,
Otto, all you guys,
Jimmy.
Fantastic.
Bob Thanks Saget
again,
for calling, and
Voss.
Stephen Lynch is tomorrow.
Voss was on fire, and now I hope someone sets him on fire outside. You fuck.
I gotta pay for golf now, is what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
All right, guys. We'll see you tomorrow night at Jones Beach, and then back on the radio on Monday.
Bye.
Stay tuned for Ron and Fez.
This will not be over quickly. You will not enjoy this.
Well, that was fun.
Opie and Anthony.